Decision makers contend with information about educational interventions and programs claiming to be effective in improving students' learning. However, not all of those claims are supported by high-quality research. The ability to effectively review the research on a given intervention or program and assess its quality is critical for decision makers and educational practitioners so that they can decide which interventions or programs merit consideration for implementation. Understanding the components of research study design will help practitioners critically evaluate the evidence level of studies and instructional practices and better understand which ones are evidence-based. In this video, we will go over 7 key components of a research study and discuss what to focus on for each component so that you can assess its overall quality. The 7 components are research questions, literature review, the research design, the population and sample, measures, the findings and results, and the discussion and limitations. Research questions are one of the most important indicators of the quality of a research study. Research questions guide how the study will be conducted. Moreover, the questions should be well-defined, clear, and specific. Research questions in the research study should be relevant to your interests and needs. This is not an indicator of quality, but it does help you identify studies that will be useful to you. Let's look at research questions in more detail. In a research-based study, research questions should require analysis to provide an answer. Questions with obvious answers that can be answered with a simple statistic or that are judgment-based are not quality research questions. For example, what is the high school graduation rate in South Carolina? Is not a high-quality research question. It is too narrow and it can be answered with a simple statistic. Questions that can be answered with a yes or a no should also typically be avoided. Instead, a good research question can focus on factors related to graduation rates or whether the policy or practice has an impact on graduation rates or differences between groups or schools or students in terms of their graduation rate. Moreover, research questions should be feasible, specific, focused, measurable, and clear. The language should be clear and terms well-defined. In addition, it should be clear exactly what is being asked and will be answered by the study. A literature review is an essential feature of any research article. An effective review creates a foundation for the research study by linking the study to the relevant theories and prior research in the field. It helps the reader see what is already known or believed about the topic, identifies how this study expands our understanding of the topic, and provides the theoretical basis for the research being conducted. An effective literature review provides a theoretical framework and the conceptual basis for the study based on relevant citations to prior scientific studies. You can evaluate the citations by seeing how up-to-date they are and whether they reference findings of research studies. High-quality studies should also provide information about how the study contributes to, challenges, and/or extends the current knowledge base, practice, and/or methodology in the relevant field. A research design is a specific method a researcher uses to collect, analyze, and interpret data to answer his or her research questions. The research design falls into one of two broad categories: qualitative research designs and quantitative research designs. A qualitative research design focuses on things in the natural setting and seek in-depth understanding of underlying meanings, the why, of social phenomena. A quantitative research design is used to examine the relationship between variables to explain and analyze that relationship mathematically through statistical analysis. Both approaches can be used separately or together. There are 3 main types of quantitative research design: descriptive, correlational, and experiments. There are 2 types of experiments: randomized controlled trials and quasi-experimental designs. Correctly identifying research design of the study is important because each research design has its own advantages and limitations. In terms of providing evidence for the effectiveness of the interventions, well-designed randomized controlled trials and some well-designed quasi-experimental designs can provide strong evidence. Another key section in research articles is the population and sample. Researchers may want to study a group of people, such as fifth graders or English learner students. This is the target population of the study. It is usually too large to study directly, since it includes everyone who meets a particular criterion. As a result, most studies are conducted with a part of the target population, a sample. Findings from the study sample are then generalized to the larger population. In reviewing a research article, it is important to understand the target population and sample of the study so that you can judge the extent to which the findings of the study apply or generalize to the group you are interested in. Another important component of research is the quality of the study measures. Poorly designed measures lead to faulty data, which lead to flawed conclusions. Reliability and validity are critical for helping to evaluate the quality of the measures. Reliability is the extent to which a measure produces stable and consistent results. Validity is the extent to which the scores from a measure represent the variable they are intended to. A bullseye can be used to compare validity and reliability and to explain why both are critical. Imagine that these target images represent the outcome measure of interest. The center of the target represents the concepts that the outcome measure claims to measure. An outcome measure with reliability produces measurements that hit the target consistently in the same general area. Two of these images represent an outcome measure with reliability. The first target represents a measure that is not reliable because the results are scattered across the whole target. The results in the second target are clustered in a single area, so this measure is reliable. The results do not need to hit the center of the target to be considered reliable. The third target represents a measure that has both validity and reliability because the results are clustered at the center of the target. In a quality research article, relevant reliability and validity information of the measures should be provided. Moreover, information about the development of the measures, how scores are calculated, and procedures for administration of the measures should also be provided. Such information is typically found in the section of the research study that describes the measures, which is typically within a broader methodology section. The results section of a research article is where the authors answer their research questions by utilizing the appropriate statistical analyses on the data. In the discussion section, authors interpret the findings in relation to other similar studies and explore the implications of the research, practice, or policy. Moreover, information about the limitations of the study should also be provided in the main text. Learn more about study design, design standards, and find existing research on different educational programs, products, practices, and explore evidence-based practice guides, individual studies, and intervention reports at the What Works Clearinghouse.